The MSR D4S V2 has been updated with a new dual-channel driver, which offers some exciting new features that add greater versatility and even more customizability to the light. This new dual-channel driver is now also available on the smaller MSR D4 V2 and the Noctagon KR4, giving those lights the same functionality. This new driver has two independent channels, which allow for two distinct sets of LEDs to work together as either a tint ramping or a channel switching flashlight. In the short time since this new driver's release, some major firmware updates have come along that improve the functionality of these lights. Where before the tint ramping and channel switching functions were only available in separate versions of the firmware, they have now been consolidated into a single build. The tint ramping version uses two sets of emitters with different color temperatures, and allows for smooth ramping between the two as a means of setting the desired color temperature. This light has two sets of Nichia 219B LEDs in 2700K and 4500K color temps. This allows for ramping the light from neutral white to warm white, or setting it anywhere in between. After the temperature is set, the output can then be ramped as desired. The set temperature can also be memorized. This tint ramping style basically allows for a completely custom tint mix, and any two LEDs can be used to dial in the perfect beam, which can be easily changed as desired. The channel switching firmware function instantly swaps between the two channels, and is useful when selecting emitters that offer contrasting throwy and floody beams, or white and colored emitters, for sort of two-in-one multi-purpose flashlight. This switching version will be preferred for some configurations, as the beams may not mix together very well, and this allows for rapid instant switching of beam types. This light here has 5000K Cree XPL HDs on one channel, and Osram CSLNM1, or W1, LEDs on the other channel. Channel 1 provides a very nice floody beam for wide area lighting, while switching to channel 2 provides a more intense beam, which has great long-range throw. These lights run Toykeeper's Anduril 2 firmware, which is already set up for easy channel switching and tint ramping without affecting normal operation. While the light is on, press 3 times and hold on the last press. The switching version will instantly switch channels, while the ramping version will smoothly transition channels as the button is held down. A quick double press will activate turbo, which runs all emitters at max power. By default, Anduril uses automatic memory, and however the light is set will be memorized and recalled when the light is shut off and turned back on again. The tint ramping model has another cool trick up its sleeve. If the button is held after the light reaches the end of the channel ramp, it will enable a special mode that automatically changes the temperature alongside the main brightness ramp. This happens at both ends, so the light can either start warm while the light is low, and get cooler as the output increases, or it can be set to do the opposite, and get warmer as the brightness increases. Simply repeating the three presses and a hold will revert back to manual tint ramping. Both the tint ramping and the channel switching functions are available in the same firmware. Changing between these two is very easy to do in the UI. From off, pressing 9 times and holding on the last press will enter the hardware configuration mode. When the light begins blinking, a single press will enter channel switching mode, and doing nothing will revert to tint ramping mode, which is the default setting. Any combination of LEDs can be selected while purchasing, so you can pretty much order whatever configuration works best for your needs. The product listing for this new D4S V2 has tons of options available, so you can go crazy and put together whatever you want. The new driver also allows for a lighted switch to be used on the D4S V2, which is a very nice feature that wasn't available before. While this dual channel setup does allow for some very cool new possibilities, there are a couple of downsides you should be aware of. Because there are only two emitters per group, each channel produces around 2000 lumens with very efficient LEDs, and the lack of FET control for all emitters will reduce the maximum possible output for turbo. This does mean the light won't heat up much, which is actually really nice, but it's definitely not the hot rod that the more standard MSR lights can be. The good news is that the output is fully regulated and has consistent output even at the highest levels. In normal operation, the tint ramping version is designed to maintain its output regardless of the selected temperature. But once the light reaches its output ceiling, tint ramping will begin to change the brightness. The current channel setting is overridden on turbo, as all LEDs run at their maximum output. Because of the way this driver is configured, the output will be a bit lower than the standard driver. In either channel switching or tint ramping setting, activating turbo with two presses from on will run both channels at their maximum output. The behavior of turbo can also be configured in the latest versions of Anduril. This new driver still uses the same microcontroller and the same flashing pads as the other MSRs, so it can be reflashed just as easily. Purchasing the flashing kit is highly recommended, as their firmware is still fairly new and is still in active development. Toykeeper, the developer, is currently working to improve the power delivery and add new features, so the flashing kit will allow you to keep the lights up to date with current software releases. Again, it is highly recommended to purchase the flashing kit along with the light to stay updated with the latest firmware.